Martin, how important is it for you to be a consistent scorer on this team this year, without Maimon out in particular?
I mean, I think it's real important. We need that third score. Really going to the SEC besides Trey and John Hill, because they're going to be really keyed on down in the SEC, so I think it's real important.
You've been more consistent this year than a year ago. Is that just a year of maturity? Is there something that, or do you like coming off the bench? What's led to that?
I think it's a little of both. I just had to learn what shots to take, more or less, and attack more rather than just shoot threes.
Jordan, you guys have a good idea that Jerron wasn't coming back. Did you guys already kind of feel like he wasn't going to be with the team?
I mean, Jerron was always around, you know, talking to us. We never really talked to him too much about it. I mean, so it was always up to him or whoever, or Chad, I guess.
So you guys didn't expect the news that he was going to register?
We didn't know.
Is there a letdown then for the team? You know, in the back of your mind, you might have been thinking, well, we're doing okay, but when Jerron comes back, how good this team could be? Or is there a letdown now knowing you can't come back?
I mean, I don't think it's as much as a letdown because we've been practicing and preparing as if he wasn't going to come back. And Jerron, even though he's not playing, he's still a huge part of our team. He talks and practices and on the game. He's always talking. He's like another coach out there for us.
How much stock do you put in starting or not starting a game? Coach says in his conversations with you that maybe doesn't really matter, does it?
No, it doesn't matter.
Jordan, can you look ahead? You guys, you won't have Jerron for the rest of this season, but knowing that you will have him next season and how good that team could be next year, maybe, have you thought about that at all?
No, I haven't really thought about it. We're just mainly focused on this year, still trying to be a NCAA tournament team, and I'm just trying to do as much as we can in the SEC.
Just looking at your team and how you've played so far to get to that goal of being an NCAA tournament team, what do you think you have to improve?
I think we have to improve it in all areas. I think our team and our big men have been doing well, and we just have to keep getting better and making strides every day.
I know you went 10-6 last year in the SEC and still didn't get the NCAA in the non-conference. You had a couple non-conference wins this year, quality non-conference wins this year, but is there a concern with the way the SEC performed early this season out of conference games that maybe being slightly above 500 in the conference might not be good enough to get a bid or just put more pressure on the conference play now?
I mean, I think the SEC is a solid conference no matter what. You still got Florida, Kentucky, Missouri, teams like that who are in still highly ranked. So, I mean, if you win those games, I think it should be enough to get you in the tournament.
Seems to be, we're talking about Schuyler and some other guys maybe not shooting the ball quite as well. Is that, you guys talk among yourselves? Is that something you guys are worried about?
No, I mean, I feel like we all go through those slumps. And if you haven't gone through it yet, then it's going to happen. So, I mean, that's just something you just got to keep on. We're working on. Keep shooting.
Jordan, how were you guys actually told that Jerron's redshirting and it's a done deal? He's not coming back.
I seen it yesterday on Twitter. And, that was pretty much it.
Is that where you get a bunch of actual team meeting or anything? As a manager?
No.
Jordan, if you were put in a situation like that where maybe you could play, you know, the last month or two of the season or get a whole extra year, any idea how you might handle that?
Well, I mean, I think in Jerron's, his situation is different. Jerron's game is a lot of power and muscle, and that's how he plays. And being out for that long, I would just rather have my whole year than try to come back in the bulk of the season when we play our hardest games. So I'd rather come back and just get a whole new year.
Do you think y'all have adjusted pretty well to playing without him?
I mean, yeah, I think we have. Just like I said, we've really been telling our bigs we all need them to step up and play as if Jerron's not coming back before we knew he wasn't. So I think they're prepared for it, and they know what they have to do in the SEC.
Will this affect any of your leadership role with him out?
I mean, Jerron's always, like I said, he's always there. He's talking to us every game and on the sideline and he's like a coach out there for us. So, I mean, I don't think so. I mean, just on the court now, we just need more players to step up on the court.
Jordan, what do you remember about Ole Miss? Y'all played a couple of really pretty interesting games against them last season to come back at home. I guess the one tournament, obviously, that didn't go the way y'all wanted to go. What do you remember about that?
I mean, I don't remember much. I just know that they attacked the offensive boards hard. They had two really big guys down there, so we're gonna have to guards gonna have to rebound a lot come Wednesday. That's pretty much all I know.
Ole Miss always seems like a really physical team too. Y'all kind of like that, don't you? I mean, they kind of like to muscle up and, like you said, attack the offensive glass. You know, they got some of the big strong guys. Do y'all like playing those kind of teams?
I mean, it's always fun playing a team that, you know, plays like us. It's kind of like how it is in practice for us. So, yeah, I guess you can say that.